probably the chief, sir. They're here for their briefing on the Naval and Marine Corps maneuver.
Oh, yes. Come in. At ease. Amanda, this is going to be short and to the point. This week, we are holding joint amphibious maneuvers with the Marines. Now, last year, there was considerable conflict between the two services. This year, however, things are going to be different. There will be no name-calling. There will be no fighting. There will be no friction of any kind. Is that clear?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Any questions?
No, sir.
Good. Dismissed.
Sir, I have a question.
I thought I was going to get off easy.
Sir, what if one of those jerky Marines calls one of us a swabby? What are we supposed to do?
You will pretend you didn't hear him. Understand?
Yes, sir. Sir, what happens if one of those skinheads says that one Marine can take on five sailors? Are we supposed to take that?
You will do as I told you. Fleet Command wants no fighting, and there will be no fighting. Is that understood?
Yes, sir.
One more time.
No fighting.
Good.
Yes, sir. Sir.
Now what?
Sir, what if someone gets in a sneak punch and no one sees it? Would you consider that fighting, sir?
Chief Sharkey.
Yes, sir.
My philosophy is live and let live. There will be no fighting. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
And if you say or do anything to provoke our Marine guests, you'll be up the creek without a paddle. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
One more time. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Good. Dismissed.
Aye, sir. But, Captain...
Dismissed! Aye, sir.
What started that rivalry between the Navy and the Marine Corps? What's it based on?
Stupidity, Whipple. Stupidity. And the fact that people fail to recognize that wars are won by the joint efforts of all the services. The Army, the Navy, the Marines, the Air Force. They should all share equally in the credit. Even though without the Navy, the rest of them aren't worth a damn.
Yes, sir.
Come in.
Buckner, you old son of a gun. How are you?
Hannigan, Hard Rock Hannigan, the pride of the Marines. How have you been?
Couldn't be better.
Oh, this is my aide, Lieutenant Whipple.
Whipple?
Hi.
Get the colonel a chair,
Whipple. Yes, sir.
Well, Buck, here we go again, huh?
Yeah.
The Navy and the Marines working together as a team.
Right, a team.
That's the way it should be. The Navy takes us to the scene of the battle. We fight the war. The Navy picks us up and takes us home again. Team effort.
Now, wait a minute. What do you think comes out of those big guns to clear the beaches so your men can walk ashore? Midgets to work in circuses?
Excuse me, sir. May I say something here?
What is it, Whipple?
Well, sir, if I may say so, I mean, each service does their own thing. The Navy does its thing, and the Marine Corps does its thing. And by each service doing their own thing, it allows us both to do our thing together. And that's the whole thing.
I'll bet you're from Annapolis.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Well, Buck, I gotta run. I'll see you at the briefing tomorrow.
All right, Hannigan.
Remember, semper fi.
Semper fi, you didn't even take your semper fi.
Hey, Hunt!
Okay, as you were, gather round. This'll be brief. This week, the Navy and the Marines are gonna go on maneuvers together.
Are you?
What do you think you're looking at, some topless dancer with a set of bad lamps? Now, the word for the week is cooperation. The Marines are our guests, and we, the Navy, are their hosts.
What happened to you, Apodaca?
Well, some Marine took a poke at me, so I took a poke at some Marine.
Apodaca, Buckner doesn't want any fighting. Now, I'm not going to take the blame for this. Where were you, and what were you doing?
I was taking a walk. You know, I like to walk. Window shop, sightseeing.
All right, Apodaca.
Yeah, I look at the birds, the trees, the clouds.
All right, Apodaca, shut up. Pruitt?
Yeah, Chief.
Pruitt, I want you to make a visit to the Marines.
All right, Chief.
And look up this guy's corporal. And tell him Apodaca has a violent streak in him from watching too many cartoons on television.
Yeah, what's cartoons, public
shut
television?
Shut up, Apodaca. Come here, Pruitt. I want you to find this corporal and tell him that we don't want any trouble. We don't want any violence. No violence.
Do I have to, Chief?
Yeah. Otherwise, I'm going to unscrew your navel and let your legs fall off. Come in. Come in. Pruitt, what happened?
Well, Chief, I sprained my ankle.
I went down and talked to this Marine corporal and explained about Apodaca just like you told me to.
And?
Well, one word led to another, and we started pushing and shoving one another.
And then what?
Well, he knocked off my glasses, so I bent down to pick them up. That's when he kicked me. I sort of got mad.
Pruitt, you're not supposed to get mad.
What was I supposed to do, Chief? Turn the other cheek?
Did you hit him?
Oh, no. I just pushed him. Oh, down a flight of stairs.
Then, Pruitt, why are you on crutches?
He took me with him.
Pruitt, the captain's gonna blow his top when he hears about this. I better go down there myself.
Yeah, Chief, I'll go with you. I can help you out.
What could you do in your condition?
Well, I'm gonna take this crutch and wrap around that good old boy's head.
Pruitt, how would you like it if I take those crutches and stick them in your ear and we play airliner?
Play airliner? Boy, even in a time of crisis, you still come up with them, Chief. Shoot. Airliner.
I'm in.
Chief Sharkey.
That's right, Sergeant.
I'm Fowler from the Marine Detachment.
Isn't that weird? I was just saying to the guys, I should go down and visit my Marine buddies because we're their hosts.
Save your breath, Chief. I got one man with cuts and bruises and another man laid up with a sprained ankle on account of some Navy clown shoved him down a flight of stairs.
Oh, I can explain that.
Nah, don't give me no explanations. I'm just telling you, if my guys bust loose, there won't be an unbruised swabby in San Diego.
Hey, fella, don't threaten me. All I'm trying to do is avoid trouble.
Well, then you try avoiding me because I don't like you. I don't even know you and I don't like you.
Yeah? Well, you could use a few personality shots yourself.
What's that mean?
That means why don't you take a cab into the harbor with the windows open?
Hey, wise guy, eh?
Yeah.
Well, I'll tell you what, Blabbermouth. You and me, the Navy against the Marines.
You got it right here.
Oh, no. I want an audience when I clobber you.
Okay, okay. 1 week from today, right here at the gym.
You got it.
Okay, I'm going to take you apart.
Yeah, and I'm going to give it to you right into the bonza.
How about that, fella?
Will.
Robinson, you don't seem to understand. I'm gonna knock this guy out in the first round. I'm gonna wait for my move, wait for my opening, best shot, and then pow, pow, Captain Buckner, Lieutenant Whipple.
Chief Sharkey, I have gotten wind of some scuffling between some of the men and the Marine detachment.
Scuffling, sir? There's no scuffling. Robinson, there's no scuffling.
No, sir, no scuffling.
Sir!
Well, we definitely got wind of scuffling, and it involved the men in your barracks.
I've warned you about this, Chief. And if I hear of one more incident, do you know what I'm going to do?
What's that, sir?
I'm going to assign you to a frogman detail in a minefield off the coast of Alaska. Do you read me?
Yes, sir.
Carry on!
Yes, sir.
You heard that, didn't you? You want frogman duty in Alaska?
Robinson, I have to defend my honor. I better start training now.
Okay, I'll get you all set up at the gym. In the meantime, I'll go looking around for a searchlight and a wetsuit.
Searchlight and a wetsuit. No, no, no!
Ha ha ha! How you doing, Rob?
Where's Shark?
Oh, he's still out doing road work.
Oh, man, I hope he doesn't overdo it. Say, Scotty,
yeah.
You've been working with Shark for a couple days now.
Uh-huh.
What are his chances against Fowler?
About 50-50.
You mean he's got an even chance of winning?
No, of living. Sharky, I want you to hit the speed back for a little while.
Are you nuts?
Come on! Come on, move! Now, this is what I want you to do. Okay? Now, it's your turn.
Scotty, can I see you a minute, please?
Keep punching, champ.
Yeah, listen, I just had a thought.
Yeah.
This guy Fowler, I think he's a blowhard. I mean, I don't think he wants to fight any more than Sharky does.
So?
So if Fowler thinks Sharky has a great left, maybe he'll cancel out. What do you think?
Yeah, but Sharky doesn't have a terrific left.
Yeah. That's where my thought comes in. Now, Fowler's due at the gym in a few minutes. I mean, make Slugger Sharky look good. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, make him look good, you know?
Yeah.
Okay. Shark, come on, go a few rounds with Scotty. All right, now,
you remember everything I taught you before?
Yeah. I'm a southpaw, so I don't lead with my left.
Right.
And I keep myself a moving target.
Right.
A moving target.
That's right. Come on. Ready to go? That's it.
Keep circling clockwise.
Right. Yeah. Get it made. All right? Okay, let's go. Now, put this on. You look terrific. Like you're going to join the Easter parade.
Very funny, Robinson.
All right, there comes Fowler now. Hey, Fowler, you're early.
Who are you?
I'm Chief Robinson. I'm Sharky's second. Listen, we got the gym for another 10 minutes.
Yeah, okay. We'll wait outside.
Good. Okay, guys. On the bell. Bong! Move around.
Sorry, Scotty. What happened?
It's okay. I'm
hey,
all
forgive
right.
me. I don't know what happened.
Lucky punch.
Yeah, he's all right. Let's go.
Is he okay?
Yeah, he's all right. Come on. Run.
Yeah, I'm all right.
I knocked him down.
Yeah, good shot, Shark.
I knocked him down.
Yes. All right, you guys go take a shower, all right?
I knocked him down.
I feel like I got hit by a Mack truck.
I knocked you down.
Yeah. Did you see that? He decked him twice. Who is that guy, Shark?
Shut up. There's Robinson again.
Hey, Sergeant, I got to talk to you.
Yeah? What about?
Well, I guess you haven't heard all those stories about left hook Sharky. I mean, that left hand of his is some kind of freak lethal weapon.
What are you talking about?
Well, about 20 years ago, exhibition bout at the Brooklyn Navy Yard, Sharky killed a guy. Pow! Brain damage.
Eh?
Yeah. And didn't fight again for 10 years. Took up the violin. And then, in an exhibition bout with his local champ, Shark forgot to pull his punches and whack! They, the guys selling neckties in Florida.
I'll tell you, Robinson, you leveled with me, now I'll level with you.
Yeah.
I knocked out the light heavyweight champion of the Philippine Army. And today, that man is selling toy alligators to kids in downtown Honolulu.
Whoa, that's beautiful, isn't it, guys?
Yeah.
Man, you know, he decked Scott twice. I mean, Scotty the pro. Oh, Chief, you had this gift all along, and you didn't even know it.
Wow, look at that, brothers. That's what I call white power, huh?
Hey, Chief, can I feel your fist?
Sure, kid, go ahead.
Wow. You're gonna hit that Marine sergeant just once, he's gonna sound like this.
Oh, Sergeant, what hit me?
You know, Chief, I had to give 2-to-1 odds, but I bet $100 on you. And whatever I win, I'm gonna send it to my cousin Harriet so she can have a mole removed.
Chief, I wanna make a wish that my people make.
What's that?
Mi jefe, yo quiero que usted gane esta pelea mañana, porque yo tengo todo mi dinero a favor de usted. Y si usted pierde, yo me jodo. Pero no importa. Mm.
Now, what's that mean?
Bustes, tacos, Chief.
Give me that, Chief.
I'm sorry, I've been looking all over for you. You got to call off this fight.
Oh, no! No! Harriet, man! Are you kidding? Sure, I admit I was a little nervous, but that was before I knew about this. And you heard what Scotty said? I hit like a truck.
Shark, the guys are betting on you. What if you lose?
Oh, lose! You
can't lose. This looks to you like an ordinary fist, but really it's a lethal weapon. In fact, right now, I'm gonna start working out, and I guess my fans wanna watch me, huh?
Right, team!
He's like
Chopaloo!
Oh, Chief Sharky's got a lot of confidence, huh?
Yeah.
Boy, Captain Buckner's gonna be proud of him.
I wonder if Captain Buckner knows about this fight.
Oh, yeah, I'm sure he does.
No, maybe not. I mean, it'd be ashamed if he missed it.
Well, yeah. Maybe I ought to call over there and leave word.
That's a good idea, Pruitt.
Yeah, because it'd be a shame if he missed this fight.
Yes, you better believe it.
Yeah.
Gunnery Sergeant Fowler reporting his audit, sir.
At ease, Sergeant. You know why we sent for you?
No, sir. Come in.
Chief Shocker reporting his audit, sir.
At ease. After you, Colonel.
Thank you, Captain. It has come to our attention that you two clowns are going to have a fist fight. Is that true?
Yes, sir.
Back off, Sergeant. Captain Buckner is a friend of mine. I don't want to see him embarrassed by having one of his men beaten up. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Dismissed.
Chief Sharky.
Yes, sir.
I warned you I did not want any trouble, did I not?
Yes, sir.
And did you listen? No, you did not.
A Fowler started it, sir.
Be that as it may, the Navy and Marines are joined together for maneuvers. And it wouldn't do if Sergeant Fowler was so bruised and battered that he would be unfit for duty now, would it?
No, sir.
Then the fight is off. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
Good. Dismissed.
But, Captain...
Dismissed!
Aye, aye, sir.
Well, now, that takes care of them.
What was that crack about too bruised and battered to perform?
Well, just that I think a byman could have given a good account of himself.
Against a tough guy like Fowler?
Any day.
Not in a million years. Pound for pound, the U.S. Marine is a...
Oh, I've heard that before, and I still don't believe it.
You better believe it.
Now, you listen to me.
You listen to me, Buck. I'll tell you what's
up. Fowler, you know what?
What's that, Chief?
How about if I take you over to Chief's Club and buy you a beer?
Good thinking, Sharky.
Short time taught me a lot about boxing.
Well, you still know Muhammad Ali.
Yeah, I know that. But you know, I found out there's more to having a good punch. That's to have a good defense. You know what the best defense is?
Running?
No.
Clinch. You see, when you clinch a guy, he can't move his arms and hit you. And then you get a chance to rest.
I see.
You know what I mean? For example, come at me. Throw a couple of fake punches. I'll show you what I mean.
Okay.
You know what I mean? Okay, throw a couple of punches. See? Now. Oh, get to clinch. See? Now you can't throw punches, you can't even hit me, and it gives me a chance to rest. See? Now I walk around like this until the referee separates us. See what I mean? You can't do anything. See what I mean? Can't move, can't do a thing.
Yeah, yes, right.
Captain Buckner, Lieutenant Whipple.
Chief Shocking,
I just stopped by to tell you that the joint maneuvers went extremely well, and Fleet Command is very pleased. However, I must tell you that if there's one thing I hate worse than fighting amongst the men, it's dancing. Let's go, Whipple. I feel as though we've stopped into Roseland.
Listen, if your dance card isn't already filled, save me a waltz.